Hi there, folks, and welcome back. Yes, I know it's been a little while. I've been away dealing with the issue with the bones again. I've had a change of medications and loads of other shit. Yeah. So, yeah, I've been away dealing with that. But now I am back, feeling a bit better today, so I thought I'd crack out a quick video. And this one's been brought about by messages that have been sent to me by my two channel moderators, that being Dan Darlickman and Spider Rider. People are now running around my videos, and I don't know where they get this from, making the claim, yeah, that unless a MC is flying a 1% diamond, it's not a real MC. So what were they then, is my question, before they started flying the 1% diamond? What were they then before they started to fly the 13 diamond? Yeah? They were still MCs, they were still motorcycle clubs, yeah? So how all of a sudden, yeah, has it come into being that if you're not flying a 1% diamond, then you're not a real MC? And I'll be honest with you, you people that make this claim are highly uneducated, yeah, when it comes to the history, the timeline of MC motorcycle clubs, okay? Patches on the back and all this type of stuff, yeah? With MC designation were there a long time, yeah, before the 1% diamond ever appeared. The 1% diamond, in fact, is something quite new, really, when you look at the whole timeline of the creation of motorcycle clubs. Now, in the United Kingdom, that goes back to 1901. Okay, so that's a huge timeline we're talking about here, before that patch ever existed. Okay, and that patch came basically from another designation that people used to wear on their waistcoats, the 13 patch. Now, if you go back and you look through my video library, you'll find I made a video about this stuff, okay? So the 1% diamond designation is quite a new thing when you look at the timeline of how long motorcycle clubs have been around, okay? Now, and then to make this claim, I mean, what an insult. What an insult to the clubs that fly MC on their backs, yeah? To be told, oh, you're not a real MC because you're not flying a 1% diamond, so you're not a real MC. Are you fucking kidding me? Really, what an insult to those clubs. I know a hell of a lot of clubs out there that fly the MC designation on their backs, yeah, that don't fly a 1% diamond, but they're still as hardcore as any other backpatch club you could ever cross paths with. Absolutely. You know, I mean, that whole 1% thing didn't appear in the United Kingdom until, I think, about the 1970s. So it's a relatively new thing. So what you're saying is all these clubs are still going to this day that predate that time that still don't fly a 1% diamond. You're telling me that those are not real motorcycle clubs? Get the fuck out of here with that shit. Seriously, coming here and spurting that crap off and responding to other people's comments with that very comment. Really? What an insult. What an absolute uneducated insult that is. Can't believe it. Really? Well, I'm telling you, it doesn't matter whether a club's wearing a 1% diamond on their waistcoat or not. An MC club that flies it on their back with an MC designation that's gone through all the work to be able to put it there is a real MC. Regardless of what you small-minded, uneducated people seem to think, okay? They are real MCs, and I know a hell of a lot of them. Yeah, I know a hell of a lot of them. And it is a bloody insult to those clubs to make that kind of claim. You obviously don't know or understand the timeline. Yeah, I suggest you get out there and get yourself educated on this stuff. Unbelievable. There are literally tens of thousands of clubs the world over that fly an MC backpatch that don't fly a 1% diamond. You're telling me that every single one of those clubs is not a real MC? Really? Get the fuck out of here. Seriously. This sort of stuff is the stuff that balls my piss, and I know it balls the piss of the people that have gone through the work, the time, the dedication and everything to get that. Yeah? To get that MC three-piece backpatch, and you're trying to tell them people that they're not a real MC? Get out of here. Total insult. Now, on closing of this video, yeah, there are three clubs that are on my friends list on Facebook, so you guys will know who you are. I just want to extend a massive, massive congratulations to you guys, all of you, yeah, from working your way up the old school way. You worked it from the front and now you're wearing it on the back. Big respects to you guys. Okay, big respects, and I hope there are bigger and bigger things for you guys in the future. Yeah, you guys have really earned it, and you've earned it the old school way. Anyway, that's all I wanted to say on that topic for today. I'm hoping to do a live stream this Sunday. I've had a lot of contact coming in from different MCCs around the country that are begging me to touch on this issue about MCCs and the direction that some of them seem to be taking these days. So I might actually make that this Sunday's live stream topic. So if you're in an MCC and you want to take part in that, yeah, tune in on Sunday. If I'm feeling great, it will be at 10 p.m. Sunday evening UK time. Okay, so you all stay safe. Hope to see you at the weekend, and I'll catch you another day, another way. Bye now.